dear Katie, you cannot know how happy I am that you will get to see the park before we officially open to the public. You should know that all this you see around you comes from our talks in the hospital. Daddy was paying attention, and he used your drawings for inspiration. When I showed them to my friend, Dr. Quinzel, she said you were a very talented little girl, and that I was a very lucky father. Don't I know it? But what happened to us, what happened to you, changed my life for the better. Even Dr. Quinzel says I'm much more alive and present since I gave up work to take care of you. Actually, come to think of it, she was the one who suggested I build this place for us. To inspire me, she introduced me to a strange man in a purple suit who gave me a lot of unique ideas for the park. He calls himself Jack White. He's got a great laugh and sense of humor. I think you'd really like him. When the doctors told me there was nothing more they could do for you, and that you were going to die. We can be grateful to Jack for referring us to Dr. Penelope Young, who did for you what traditional medicine couldn't. It's because of her special treatments that you're here today. I thank Jack endlessly for referring us, and even offered him a new wardrobe. But he told me he was quite satisfied with his wardrobe and didn't seem too pleased about the suggestion. I really hope I didn't offend him after all he's done for us. So easy getting this place up and running. Some inspectors nearly shut us down, but Jack somehow convinced them to change their minds. As a thank you gesture, I bought him a new purple suit imported from Italy. But he said it was violet, and that he only wore purple on account that purple keeps him grounded. I guess your daddy doesn't know the difference between purple and violet. In any case, I have to get Jack something meaningful to thank him for all his help throughout this ordeal. Kitty died before she could see the park. Jack blamed me and said I should never have taken her to Gotham General in the first place. But how was I to know? He told Dr. Young to triple the dosage of her alternative meds, but that only seemed to make things worse. She died last week, and the pain is unbearable. Dr. Quinzel says it won't get better. She says the pain will just get worse, and that there's no point in going on. She's right. She always is. I signed the park over to Jack, and my only hope is that he does something inspiring with it. As for me, I'll be with Katie soon. These pills Jack gave me will make sure of that. They're supposed to be painless.
Need to get below.
It really is. And why? Because I'm concerned. Deeply concerned. You see, Batman hasn't been himself these past few months. If he's not late, he's exhausted. If he's not exhausted, he's preoccupied, making all kinds of silly mistakes. I believe they call it baby brain. Best way to cure baby brain is to get rid of the...
There.
Who is he calling a baby?
Not you.
Better not.
You think Batgirl can save me?
I'm okay, Batgirl. But I can't say the same for Gordon. Joker's got him. He's planning something sick.
I have to free the hostages.
You morons don't know what you're talking about!
Hey, imagine you found this dinosaur's DNA in a bug stuck in orange glass.
Give him! How the bugs get into the orange glass? How come the glass is orange back then?
It's here.
I need to free those hostages before it's too late.
Thanks, Batgirl. Listen, you need to be careful. I heard Joker's men talking about some trap for you and Robin. He wants to kill you both as some sort of sick Valentine's gift to Batman.
Not safe here. Fine.
What was that?
A bad joke.
Joker tends to make a lot of those.
He's about to make his last one.
Batgirl, I've located Joker at the main tent. I just sent you my location.
Chance he has my cat. What was that?
Came from the main tent. Hurry, Barb.
How'd you get here?
I have my ways.
Welcome, one and all, to Joker's main event. Tonight's special act, the magnificent deaths of the Gate to
Robins were good luck.
He missed, didn't he?
Batgirl! We'll scoop him out later.
He hurt my dad, Tim.
Call in air support and the Coast Guard. Put out an APB on Joker.
Your dad's safe now. That's all that matters.
You two okay?
We're good, Commissioner.
You saved many lives tonight, including my own. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You sure you're okay, Batgirl?
Get
her out of here!
Dear Katie, you cannot know how happy I am that you will get to see the park before we officially open to the public. You should know that all this you see around you comes from our talks in the hospital. Daddy was paying attention, and he used your drawings for inspiration. When I showed them to my friend, Dr. Quinzel, she said you were a very talented little girl, and that I was a very lucky father. Don't I know it? Understand this, but what happened to us, what happened to you, changed my life for the better. Even Dr. Quinzel says I'm much more alive and present since I gave up work to take care of you. Actually, come to think of it, she was the one who suggested I build this place for us. To inspire me, she introduced me to a strange man in a purple suit who gave me a lot of unique ideas for the park. He calls himself Jack White. He's got a great laugh and sense of humor. I think you'd really like him.
Joker. Just makes sense. Of course not. Batman ain't white like Joker. We see through the mask, you meathead.
Watch out.
Joker tends to make a lot of those.
He's about to make his last one.
Batgirl, I've located Joker at the main tent. I just sent you my location.
Chance he has my cap. What was that?
Came from the main tent. Hurry, Barb.
How'd you get here?
I have my ways.
Welcome, one and all, to Joker's main event. Tonight's special act, the Magnificent Deaths of the Eight Joker. Come in!
Batgirl can save me.
I'm okay, Batgirl. But I can't say the same for Gordon. Joker's got him. He's planning something sick.
I have to free the hostages.
You morons don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, imagine you found this dinosaur's DNA in a bug stuck in orange glass.
How the bugs get into the orange glaze?
I need to free those hostages before it's too late.
Thanks, Batgirl. Listen, you need to be careful. I heard Joker's men talking about some trap for you and Robin. He wants to kill you both as some sort of sick Valentine's gift to Batman.
Not safe here. Fine.
What was that?
A bad joke.
The scariest day was when the doctors told me there was nothing more they could do for you. And that you were going to die. We could be grateful to Jack for referring us to Dr. Penelope Young, who did for you what traditional medicine couldn't. Because of her special treatments that you're here today. I thank Jack endlessly for referring us, and even offered him a new wardrobe. But he told me he was quite satisfied with his wardrobe and didn't seem too pleased about the suggestion. I really hope I didn't offend him after all he's done for us. So easy getting this place up and running. Some inspectors nearly shut us down, but Jack somehow convinced them to change their minds. As a thank you gesture, I bought him a new purple suit imported from Italy. But he said it was violet, and that he only wore purple on account that purple keeps him grounded. I guess your daddy doesn't know the difference between purple and violet. In any case, I have to get Jack something meaningful to thank him for all his help throughout this ordeal. Kitty died before she could see the park. Jack blamed me and said I should never have taken her to Gotham General in the first place. But how was I to know? He told Dr. Young to triple the dosage of her alternative meds, but that only seemed to make things worse. She died last week, and the pain is unbearable. Dr. Quinzel says it won't get better. She says the pain will just get worse, and that there's no point in going on. She's right. She always is. I signed the park over to Jack, and well, my only hope is that he does something inspiring with it. As for me, I'll be with Katie soon. These pills Jack gave me will make sure of that. It was You're supposed to be painless.
Need to get below.
Yes, they're
to for anyone. It really is. And why? Because I'm concerned. Deeply concerned. You see, Batman hasn't been himself these past few months. If he's not late, he's exhausted. If he's not exhausted, he's preoccupied, making all kinds of silly mistakes. I believe they call it baby brain. Best way to cure baby brain is to get rid of the...
There.